fluctuating patterns of education due to globalization, the academic trend of world shifts from time to time. It is unstable and dependent upon the world's demands and the emergence of new learners. McKinnon State University currently adopted the newly modified curriculum, the K-12 curriculum, in which all the world's countries have long started to implement. To cope up with this change of the curriculum, there have become intensive adjustments in the Bukidnon State University High School Laboratory.
Here at Bukidnon State University, the Senior High School Department opened the academic tracks, specifically Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics STEM, or the STEM.
With another 2 additional years in high school, problems arose basically with regards to facilities, manpower for teachers, the training that the teacher needs, the learning resources. Everything revolves around the adjustment due to the transition period.
However, after 4 years of adopting the changes in curriculum, let's see how some teachers perceive the situation in accommodating the senior high school.
Okay, good morning. My name is Flores John Derrick. I've been teaching in the senior high school for about almost 2 years now. And,
Hi, good afternoon. I'm Bridget Ann Cuevas. I'm currently teaching full-time here in the senior high school for Introduction to World Religions and Belief Systems, and then the second subject is research. I'm also handling social sciences subjects in the college for Rizal for this semester.
My insights about the K-12 curriculum is that this is a very positive move from the government to enact a revision of our educational system, considering the fact that in the whole world, internationally, there have only been 2 nations, 2 countries that still follow the old curriculum of first year to fourth year high school before entering college. And the Philippines is one of them. Everyone else in the other countries have already enacted the K-12 program. Now, I believe this can be very useful for our students. I know that there have been sacrifices that needs to be made, that need to be made, considering that this is an additional 2 more years in school. But then again, with that 2 more years, one can opt not to attend college, especially considering conditions in life. With the K-12 program, it allows our students to be employable. By the time they graduate, they will be eligible for all of these legal matters concerning things like looking for a job or starting their own business. The K-12 will also provide our students the necessary experience and knowledge to tackle these sort of real-life situations. And overall, it will benefit them greatly, I believe. Despite all the needed sacrifices for the K-12 program, this will help our students in the long run.
So, about the K-12 curriculum, I appreciate that it's being implemented in our country. The change in our educational system came very late compared to other Asian countries, and having taught since last year in the senior high school, I can see that it is of students, because there are really subjects which some are even more difficult than the college subjects, so it's a very good preparation for them. And with their entrep subject and their research subject, it's really a good forming ground for them to be better students in college. Today we are having our NTEP product launching. I think you can see that their products are very marketable also. So hopefully some of these products will jump off and be continued by the students even after the school year or the semester, and build a business. Our F&B students they already engaged in part-time work as restaurant servers, waiters, things like that. So I can see that the curriculum is being true to its promise that the students would become entrepreneurs or they're ready for jobs after the grade 12 or after graduating in senior high school with grade 12. And then if they prefer, then they can also go to college. And I think they will really be better students in college.
A lot of the problems coming from the senior high school teachers today mostly comes from sometimes we are understaffed. We lack the necessary manpower to teach most of our some of the classes. Sometimes the class populations can be high, but that has been better managed this semester. Last semester there were some inconsistencies considering the number of students that have entered well beyond our expectations. But now that has been resolved, we still have issues regarding proper classrooms, I believe. And of course, there's also a number of student behavior. Considering students, even though they're supposed to be in college by now, they still don't behave like real college students. They feel very childish and sometimes they don't take their education more seriously. But that's just for a handful of students, and the teachers themselves have to deal with those kinds of students. Some of the other problems involved in teaching the senior high school is nothing really out of the ordinary. Much more like, much like the problems any other teacher would encounter, but the problems we encounter is really nothing special, but mostly concerns our students themselves.
Here in VSU, majority would be, the major problem would be classroom, availability of classroom, and the facilities. There are rooms which have leaking ceiling. Although the chairs are enough, there are rooms which do not have a whiteboard, and then we lack the LPs also. And then we cannot secure our classrooms because it is being used by college classes in the evening. And then in the ELS, we are using two classrooms. The lighting is... the lighting needs attention because in one classroom there are only four fluorescent bulbs functioning, so it gets dark in the afternoon or especially when it rains. It's difficult to hold the class for the students to read. Basically, that's it, the classroom and facilities. During the early period of the offering of the senior high school here, the teachers had problems with delayed salary because the administration had to reconcile the big number of teachers transferring from the college to the senior high school. The arrangement was, it took like a couple of months before we started receiving our salary from the beginning of the school.
I believe majority of our students are actually very well behaved. They take their education seriously. And I believe once they graduate, some of them, a significant portion of our students, will probably want to pursue a college degree. Some of our students have opted not to get a college degree and actually just start their own business or start looking for a job. Majority of them are ready. But sadly, there is still a handful who we've encountered recently that do not seem to take the education that seriously. They're already 17 years old, some of them are already 18 years old, but they like to behave like teenagers. They believe that they're going to be teenagers forever. Like, we are dealing with students who reportedly before, we having reports that they're drinking on school nights. It's like these are the same students who are trying so hard to have to be able so that they'll graduate this semester. But sadly, some of our students still has not yet matured that enough. But I'm glad to know though that regardless of these problem students, a vast majority of our students are actually ready to face these sort of problems in the future. They're ready for real life. They just need a little bit more teaching, a little bit more experience, and that's how things work in the real world. But I believe they should be ready by the time they graduate.
How the students behave?
They're generally okay. Although last year we had a big problem on absenteeism and tardiness.
Some are not yet sure of what course to take in college. Most of them are really interested in pursuing a college education and not to go to work after graduating. So, at least for here in GSU. But for generally, for most of them, they're not yet ready.
Now, the instructional materials for the senior high school has only been fairly recent. We have been given, actually, instructional materials from CHED themselves. Actually, we also received some instructional materials from DEP. And we like to employ those instructional materials, considering the fact it makes our job that much more easier, since we don't have to come up with new IMs. We can just follow the stipulated IMs from these various organizations, educational organizations, and it makes our job that much more easier. And of course, the IMs themselves are actually pretty well made. They adapt to the students' needs and they make everything transition that much more smoothly.
School does. They give us markers, chalk, everything. Paper, copy, they provided us with a computer to use, we have internet connection, class records, folders, etc. from the students. The books, the students pay for their books. The school orders the books from the publishers or from the agents of the publishers, and then the students pay for their books. The teachers are provided with a copy of the textbook, and also teacher's manual if it's available from your publisher. We are provided from but the students pay.
Of course, there are various trainings assigned to us, and we took before we actually taught senior high school. Now, when I was teaching back in college, we were informed that we would be transferred to the senior high school. And now, before we could transition to the senior high school, we underwent several training programs directly from CHED themselves. We had a seminar in Sikagayandio City, along with other universities here in Danao. We had participants from CMU, from the, I forgot the name of the other universities, but and after that we also had various seminars in order to properly transition to the senior high school curriculum. Not only that, but we were also given the various, as we said before, the instructional materials and all the things we need in order to teach senior high school. And lastly, we were given orientations and how to deal with senior high schools and how to cope with them, especially considering that by now they should be college, but as of yet they're still in high school. So we were also taught how to deal with the grievances of our students and of course their overall well-being, and how to manage all of these things to make sure that they graduate from this program and possibly get employment or get a college degree.
Yes, of course. CHED rolled out a series of trainings before the beginning of the implementation of the K-12 curriculum, and all of us here in BSU teaching at the senior high school were able to attend. We were sent to Cagayan de Oro for trainings for 3 days, 4 days.
Absolutely. I think Bukidnon State University is well equipped to handle the senior high school program. Now, there are some quirks, some problems that may arise from this from time to time, but Bukidnon State University should have no problem handling our senior high school students. We have the facilities, we have the teachers, we have the time, we have the finances. I believe we can run the senior high school quite effectively. But of course, this is not perfect. We will encounter problems from time to time. We will encounter these things, but we've already been trained how to handle these things, these certain problems. And we're going to be doing our job from this end, but it's up to the university and how they will live up to their end of the job, because the teachers cannot do this alone. They also need the support from the university themselves. But if we can work hand in hand, I believe Bukidnon State University should have no problem running the senior high school program.
We are. But then we did not, last year during the beginning of the offering of the senior high school, we were not ready for the 700 or so students. So this year we trimmed down, we only opened the STEM strand for grade 11. And there are only two sections to continue with the grade 7, 8, 9, and 10, which has only two sections per year level. The grade 12 now, there are three sections per strand. So, but when they will graduate, two sections na lang dayon to continue with the laboratory school na arrangement. So, yes, we are ready, but we did not expect to have a lot of enrollees last year for grade 11. For this year, we were able to prepare for it, so basically we are. And then we will be able to, in terms of the problem for classroom and facilities, that will be fully addressed when the first batch of grade 12 graduates will, the first batch of grade 12 will graduate. Because we'll only have two sections na lang tayo for grade 11.